Hi again, everyone. In this video, we're going to continue our introduction to complex numbers. And in particular, we're going to sketch a region in the complex plane. Now, let's motivate our study. Why are complex numbers important? Well, complex numbers, they're basically an extension of the real numbers that you saw at school. And as I've mentioned in previous videos, complex numbers, although quite abstract, they find useful applications in many, many places in science, engineering, and technology. So here I've listed a few. And basically, a good understanding of how to work with complex numbers, in this case, how to sketch regions, well, this knowledge then gives us the power to solve more interesting, challenging, and important problems. So today's video is very basic, and we're going to look at this particular example. Sketch the region in the complex plane defined by all those complex numbers Z that satisfy the following inequalities. Okay, well, I'm going to discuss the general case first, and then we're going to solve this particular problem. So suppose Z naught is a complex number, A is a positive real number, and alpha and beta, I guess I really should have a less than or equals, less than here, and alpha and beta are real numbers that are between minus pi and pi. Well, this will represent a wedge in the complex plane. Now, I'm using the term wedge very, very loosely there. Let me give you a picture of, and you'll see what I mean. So here are our axes. All right, so first of all, we move to Z naught, say it's here, and we draw a circle around Z naught with radius A. Okay. All right, so what we would like to do is include all those complex numbers that surround the point Z naught within this radius. And let's bring this condition into play. Well, consider a horizontal line that's parallel to the real axis. We want to rotate, I guess, between the angle alpha and beta. So I'm just going to assume that alpha is negative in this case, and beta is positive. So our region is somewhere in here. Now, we have to be a bit careful, because here I've got a strictly less than. So actually, I'm going to put some dotted lines in there. And the other places we have less than or equals to, so we can actually include those edges. So here is our general region of interest. So we don't include this edge here, and you can see I've put in some dotted line there. Okay, well, our problem is similar, but you see I've got a strictly less than here, so I would change this edge to a dashed edge because I don't include that edge. So let's have a look at C and see what we can do here. Now, just before we do that, you can see, well, if alpha is minus pi and beta is positive pi, well, this will extend all the way around there and beta will extend all around there, so we'll actually get a disk. So you can see how I'm using the word wedge quite liberally there. So for our problem, Z naught equals 2i, A equals 1, alpha equals 0, and beta equals 3 pi on 4. So let's construct our wedge and put it all together. So let's go up to 2i. And draw a circle around 2i with radius 1. So notice I'm not going to include the edge here. So I'm going to draw a dotted line. Okay. All right, so let's look at our angles now. So in this case, alpha is 0, so I can just go straight out here, because remember I draw I consider a horizontal line and I want to rotate. Okay, so the first condition says that I don't do any rotation. The second condition says I rotate around 3 pi on 4 radians. And because I have less than or equals to, I don't need to draw a dotted line here. Okay, so basically I want to show you that there's an angle of pi on 4 radians down here. Okay, so where's our region? Well, it'll be in here. So we haven't included this edge, we haven't included that edge, but we do include this edge here. Okay, so let's look at the bigger picture. The first piece of information is that don't be daunted when trying to graph these complicated regions. It's slow at first, but you need to work through the problem systematically. And with some practice, you'll recognize the mathematical expressions for regions in the complex plane very quickly. Now, a good idea, if you have time, is after you come up with your region, test one or two points in the region to see if they possess the desired properties. So, for example, I could choose the point, say, 2.5i, which just lies there, and then test these inequalities to see if they hold, just as a backup. Now, I'm going to leave you with a couple of examples that I want you to try. It's important when you watch this video, just don't watch the video and be passive and expect that you're going to understand everything. The important way to understand mathematics is to do mathematics. So have a go at these problems, sketch the regions in the complex plane associated with these conditions, and enjoy.